They came from the hills and mountains, the valleys and the plains. Some were kind and gentle, and some too wild and tame.
A string of fearless hearts on an endless ball of twine.
It's the same old train, it's just a different time. Just a different time.
All right, guys. Well, we did it again. Unfortunately, this time I still didn't get it on camera. But, you know, it is what it is. Got in here late and, it's just gonna be real difficult. But four wheeler's down there. And I've been in here the last couple days and there's just been no birds here. Which is kind of abnormal for this spot. But there's been no birds in here. And I've been chasing them good the last couple days, the ones that I've been hearing. Walked a lot the last couple days. Hunted hard all week and just nothing to show for it. But today was kind of my last go at it for a couple days because it's supposed to be rainy. So I just, you know, I wanted to try to get one today. Well, after hanging out up in here, this is right up there is where I killed that first one. So, but after a couple of days of just hanging out in here and there's nothing here, I pulled the four-wheeler down there and was going to walk this bottom right here because it was too late for me to go way up top. So I was going to walk this bottom and see if any were, up there. But I got down there and I just kind of sat at the four-wheeler for a minute and I heard some gobbling up here. Well, I got up here, there's probably seven or eight birds gobbling up here. Some of them were jakes, but I mean, there's seven or eight birds between here and that little mountain right there, which is not that far. But I come walking up, walked all the way up, got to this corner right here, and he's still flopping. Got to this corner right here, and one gobbled right up here. Hold on a second. One gobbled right up here. So I snuck out and put the decoy up right here and set up. It's that tree right there. And I never heard them fly down, but it sounded like they were walking this road right here. And they got right down in here, and man, they hung down in here for 5-10 minutes. But I could hear them spitting and drumming. And I just waited a second, right about that time they come right over here, right over the hill here. And this one, he come walking up. They never really went full strut. They were full strut right as they come over the hill, but the one had let down and started running that way. Well, when he started to run, I just kind of raised up and shot this one and hoped for the best, but we got him. So we're gonna get packed up and hurry up and get out of here because the chest is not feeling very great. So we'll go ahead and get out of here, get this bird taken care of. So we'll get back with you here in a little bit. All right, guys, here he is. Still a little messed up, but another big old jelly head. All right, guys, well, it's actually the next day, and we're out here at the barn, you know, taking care of the animals and stuff, but we're just gonna go explain a little bit of the strategy behind the hunt yesterday. I had been hunting all week long and really not much of anything happening. Me and Blake got close on public land and they come to within about 70 yards, somewhere in that range, full strut, and I never would commit. That's about as close as we got. But down in the valley, you know, birds usually roost along that ridge that I've been going up and down on. And the last couple of days, they had not been in there. They weren't roosted in there. They weren't gobbling on that ridge. They weren't, you know, nothing. So, you know, I was doing the best that I could to even find a bird out there. But we got there yesterday morning, and we got there a little bit late. We got there, and we parked in the bottom. We were going to walk that bottom and see if there was anything down there that was just going to gobble or anything like that. Because most of the birds that gobble consistent, they were on the other property across the fence and all that good stuff. But we got over there, and we parked at the bottom, and I just kind of stood there for a second because they were already gobbling. And I heard them gobble up to my right, and I was like, I don't know if that's some gobbling up there or not. I know there's some in this bottom, but I'm going to walk up here and see if there's any up here. Well, as I'm walking up, you know, they keep gobbling, and I get right about to where the road curves, and there's a blind up there that I sat in my first hunt last year. And we got right where that road curves, and I stood there and listened, and there was probably 6, 7, 8 birds from me all the way up to where I'd shot that one. And the first one that I shot, I mean, the spot that I shot it in was only 250 yards up the mountain. But there was a bunch of birds roosted up there, and they were gobbling like crazy. And I didn't hear any hens, so I figured that they might, you know, they might be pretty good as far as committing. But I took the decoy out of my bag, and I set it up just right where the little creek kind of crosses over. And I peeled back just a little bit, pulled back about 30 yards, and I sat against a tree. And because there was some roosted probably 80 yards, within 80 yards at least. I couldn't see them, but I knew that if I moved any closer, they probably could have seen me. But I sat down and just took the slate call out, did a few tree yelps, and they gobbled back, so I didn't say nothing else after that. Took my hat, did a fly down, and waited for a minute, and I never heard them fly down, but I yelped again, and they gobbled back. And it sounded like they were kind of working around to my left, so I just didn't, you know, I tried to be quiet and not call as much as possible because, you know, sometimes you call too much and they won't commit. But when I yelped after I did a fly down, they gobbled back, so I shut up, and they gobbled 2 or 3 more times. Well, it sounded like they were getting closer, but they weren't sure. So I kind of, you know, muffled the yelp a little bit, and I yelped again, and they gobbled, and they were just right over the edge. And so I pulled the gun up and got ready, and probably about 2 minutes after I yelped, I was looking, and I saw a fan just over the lip easing up. And the first one come over, and there was one beside it, and they were both full strut, but they both let down, and the second one kind of come over the hill, and I guess he saw something he didn't like, but I mean, then I was in the wide open, but he come right over the edge, and he saw something he didn't like, and he was about to turn and start putting and running down the hill. So I was, you know, getting a little bit, starting to panic just a little bit, and I just put the bead on the first one and pulled the trigger, and he just, you know, luckily I hit him, because I'm going to be honest, I didn't know if I was on him or not. I just kind of had the gun up and pulled the trigger. But anyways, I made the shot, and the other one ran down the hill, and I got over there to the bird and, you know, kept him right there. Well, once I had packed everything up and was just getting ready to walk down, they started gobbling on up the hill again, probably 70, 80 yards up the hill. So I went ahead and I just got my stuff and I got out, because I'm wanting to go back in there later this week and maybe see if I can get on another one, or go back out there at some point this week and get on another one. We didn't go this morning just because I was just tired and, you know, we needed a break. But I plan to get back out there later this week. But I'm going to apologize, you know, to y'all viewers, those of y'all that watch, you know. I don't have any GoPros or anything like that. This is the only camera I have besides my phone. And it's really hard to get a kill shot, especially when you're trying to set up quick and, you know, be still, be super still. But I was just in a rush and I had the camera with me, but I didn't grab the tripod, so, you know, I didn't video, but, you know, I promise at some point I'm going to get a kill shot of either a turkey or deer or something, but I'm going to work on getting another one this week, but, just wanted y'all to know that, you know, I apologize for not getting a kill shot, but, you know, sometimes you just got to do what you got to do, but we're working on it. You know, still got a lot of time left in the season. Still probably about a month. So I've got 3 tags left. So we're gonna get after it, just see what happens. So appreciate you guys for watching. Be sure to like and subscribe to Wild Game Weekend. We're gonna have more content coming. Summertime, you know, rolling around. About to do a lot of bass fishing. So y'all stick around and like and subscribe if you haven't already. So we'll catch y'all next time.